Well, today is that day. We are at Chennai at the racetrack. We have the MV Agusta F3 with us. And I have to say that when I rode the F4, it felt like a motorcycle that was not only very expensive, but also a motorcycle that required a lot of work before you could start riding that motorcycle fast. The F3, well, it promises to be just as interesting a motorcycle, but a far simpler motorcycle to ride. But is it? Well, here we go.
The MV Agusta F3 800 was born a few years ago when the Italians decided that the 675cc three-cylinder engine needed more stroke and a higher displacement version of their Supersport was required. The beauty of this was that MV managed to create a significantly more powerful without adding any weight at all. And so, a 128 PS motorcycle suddenly gained a full 20 PS. But is 148 PS too much?
They say that the three-cylinder engine is the best part of a V-twin and an inline-four, but honestly, when you're riding a machine this kind of immediate, these are not the kind of things you're thinking. What you're thinking is, would it be possible for MV Agusta to just back this bike off just a smidgen so that when you open the gas, there's just a little bit of lag, so you have a little bit of a moment before the thing punches a hole through the air and drives you forward. It's just insanely direct. It's hard in sense of how much life this motorcycle packs into itself, but very, very impressive. Extremely, extremely impressive.
The MV Agusta 3-cylinder is a fairly trick engine with its titanium valves. But the party trick is the counter-rotating crankshaft. The crankshaft rotates backwards and reduces the gyroscopic precession-derived straight-line stability. And this is said to allow quicker inertia-free direction changes. But then again, the MV Agusta F3 800 has a really small wheelbase, just 1380mm. Just to give you an example, the new Bajaj Domina 400's wheelbase is nearly 80mm longer. The tiny dimensions and the top-drawer suspension makes for a startlingly immediate motorcycle. You think it, and it's doing it.
Wow, this is really different from what you're used to in today's small mid-displacement sports bikes, because you're sitting very close to the handlebar, you're right on top of the motorcycle. It feels like the front wheel is actually under you, and that gives this directness that is, well, exciting in the sense of feedback, but also slightly scary because it's very, very reactive to everything that you want it to do.
And when you're breathing hard from the intensity of the experience, you will remember that the MV Agusta F3 800 still draws upon the timeless lines that one Signor Tamburini drew. Lines that still cause you to pause mid-step and admire their simple beauty. I dare say the MV Agusta F3 800 looks better finished and more cohesive than the F4. And that's odd to me, but there it is. But as intense and delicious as the MV Agusta F3 800 is, it has the usual MV niggles as well. On the usability front, the MV retains that horrible switch cluster that you must battle to be able to change modes and settings for the MV's traction control and the four riding modes. It isn't for the faint of heart, I promise you. The other thing is the timing. This year, MV Agusta rolled out major changes to their Brutale 800, and these are expected to go into the F3 800 update that is probably due next year. And the MVs that have received these latest updates have been significantly improved by then, so there's a case to be made for waiting for the new F3 800 to come next year. But yes, the force is strong with this one.
Wow, the MV Agusta F3 is a total head rush. It wants everything, it wants it done, and it wants it done now, and you cannot back off or ride it having backed off. It's just like having an illegal substance in your bloodstream, for example. But on the flip side, when you back off the gas, you do realize it is an inline three-cylinder engine, which means it can do low rev work without juddering and shuddering like a V-twin. So in that sense, you might be able to actually live with this thing. Now the question is, should you be spending something like 16 lakh rupees ex-showroom Pune on a motorcycle like this? Well, I'll tell you this, your money buys you a properly exotic motorcycle. But should you buy something like this? Well, you get to decide.